The Ghana Standards Authority, while performing the exercise, took samples of some products to ascertain their authenticity and locked up some shops in cases where it was realized that the vendors sell a lot of substandard fabrics. The GSA said the exercise is to rid the market of substandard goods. Business Development Manager at the GSA, George Kojo Anti, tells City Business News the fabrics are hazardous to the skin and as such must not be allowed onto the market.
Our investigations indicated that these products were presumed largely to be substandard products. So today's exercise was to go to the market, sample products, and in cases where we realized that the suspicious fabrics were actually dominant in the shops, then in the interest of public health and safety, in the interest of consumer protection, then we would temporarily have to suspend the sale of those articles. Because if there are articles that we suspect to hold a danger for life, for human life, there is no reason why we should allow, at the point where we've seen it with our own eyes, to continue to be sold to the public. One human life lost can never be regained. So that is the nature of the exercise today.
The traders were, however, unhappy with the exercise and vehemently resisted the closure of their shops. They argued that the authorities must rather deal with persons who bring in the goods through the various borders and not the traders. The women are insisting that the Ghana Standards Authority rather tackle this issue at the borders, as they believe the problem really stems from the border. For City News, my name is Jessica Ayoko Ayi.